Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I just want to do a really quick video on how I made these faux wood floors for my pet room. As you guys can see, my animal room has carpet and my parents didn't want me to do anything with the carpet because we just replaced it a couple years ago. So we really didn't want to put anything over it. But at the same time, having animals, I'm sure you guys know that having wood floors and laminate floors is so much more convenient. So I came up with this DIY option, which leaves the carpet underneath unharmed and completely intact. And it also makes sure that your carpet is protected from any animal accidents. So as you can see, I think it looks really good. And the main thing is you have all the convenience you would with a laminate floor. It's really easy to sweep up. You can wipe any spills easy. And it can be waterproof or water resistant, depending on which type of tiles you get. And making these are really cheap, and you're only going to need two things. The first thing is this big sheet. This is actually a sheet of chloroplast that I got from Home Depot. I really like it because it's plastic and it's waterproof. So you could technically use this as is, but it's not very strong. And as you can see, the edges can easily dent. So I just knew my animals would have messed this up. Currently, we're in the middle of a pandemic, but luckily Home Depot does offer pickup. So you can order this huge piece of chloroplast. This is a 4 by 8 foot of chloroplast, and I got this for $22. And over here, this is a 3 foot by 6 foot piece that was around $20. So this one definitely gives you more bang for your buck, but depending on your space, you can get the size that you need. And it's also really easy to cut just with a box cutter. But it fits my place pretty well, so I'm not going to be doing that. The chloroplast is what's going to allow you to stick these vinyl tiles on top of. This is the Home Depot brand of the self-stick vinyl tiles, but a lot of different companies make them, and they come in all different types of quality. You can get them to actually be really thick, and you can have really professional looking tile ones where you actually use grout. But since I'm just doing this by myself and I'm not a handy person, I decided to just use these faux wood ones. They're a little bit more high end than some of the other ones, so they are a little bit thicker, as you guys can see, but they're not the extremely thick ones, so they're still really easy and pliable. And if you have a unique sized area or a unique shaped area, they're also really easy to cut, again, with a box cutter. What specific brand and type of tiling that you buy is really going to affect not only the look of your faux wood floors, but also their durability. Like I said, it comes in a lot of different qualities. There's some that are really thick, which would be a little bit more difficult to cut, but once you do it and you have it set up, it's going to last a really long time. There's others that are in the middle, and there's also some really cheap ones that aren't that much thicker than paper, but they would work if you aren't going to put anything too heavy on top of it, and if you are okay to be a little bit more delicate, and you will still have all the convenience of having laminate floors, like being able to wipe up spills. This specific box was around $20 for 15 tiles, and 30 square foot, and these ones are the water-resistant ones, but there are also some models that are waterproof. They also, like I said, come in a lot of different sizes and colors. I really like this fake wood print because I thought it looked kind of beachy and I loved all the colors. But there's also different marbles or stone effects if that's something you prefer. And you can also get a darker or lighter wood. So the basic idea is that you use these tiles, stick them onto the chloroplast completely, and then when you're done, you pretty much have faux wood floors. I think technically you could do this for an entire room, but I'm only going to do it where my animal cages are. So this is going to be where the rabbit's cage is, and then the other one is for the sugar glider's cage. Now, this whole project for both of these different faux wood floors and all of these tiles actually cost me around $80, which is a really good price considering how much I would have spent if I wanted to get real wood floors. But there's also a couple more affordable ways you could do this. The first way is obviously buying cheaper tiles. Even though they aren't going to be thick and they might have air bubbles when you stick them on, they are still going to give you the completely waterproof effect. And you can also buy certain types of contact paper that are more water resistant. Just make sure you're looking at reviews since it's hard to shop in person right now. And you really don't know if the contact paper you're getting is going to be more papery or it's going to have that glossy finish that it's going to be waterproof. The other place you could save some money is on the type of base that you use. Like I said, depending on what size of chloroplast you get is really going to affect the cost of it. Some alternatives you could use is actually a wood slab. Home Depot sells 4x8 wood slabs. It's the same size as this for around $8. The reason I didn't use that is because the wood isn't perfectly 4x8 like the chloroplast is, and wood is just a lot heavier. And even though sticking the vinyl on top of the wood would make it waterproof, if somehow anything got under the carpet or anything soaked into the wood, the actual wood isn't waterproof, so that could hold any smells. I also think it would be possible to do this with cardboard. The reason I didn't want to do that is because I wanted something that would hold up and last a long time. And I really wanted the entire section to be one big piece. But if you didn't mind having smaller pieces, I think using trifolds that you could get at Walmart or even the Dollar Tree would work really well. Okay, so I'm going to start sticking these tiles onto there. It's really self-explanatory. They just look like this. You peel them off just like a sticker, and then you stick them on. Once you stick them on, you do have a little bit of time to mess around with it to get it where you want it. But once you've stuck it on and let it sit for a couple minutes, it's pretty much glued on there. So don't try to make any changes after that. Okay, so I'm mostly done covering this piece. I just have these four sections left, and I want to show you how I do it. I'm going to try my best because I only have one hand. But you take one of these tiles and you peel it off. This is so self-explanatory. And then you just line it up and then you stick it. I'm going to leave it like that. I'll probably go through and fix it. From my experience, it's really impossible to get it to be completely perfect and flawless. Even though it looks pretty good from far away, if you look really close, there's like little gaps. But I don't know if that's just because the chloroplast isn't completely square or the tiles aren't completely square. I think if you took more time, you could definitely make it more even. But the gaps are like barely noticeable. And I think it looks really good. And I'm excited to finish this and show you guys. Okay, I just finished and I love how it looks. I feel like it looks really chic, and even though obviously you can tell that it's fake because it's just sitting on carpet, I love how durable it is. It's, you can walk on it completely. And if you guys want to see this actually being used, make sure to watch my pet room tour, which I'll do really soon. I don't feel like setting it all up right now because I don't even have everything, but yeah. Here's the finished product. I'm really excited for it to work for my rabbits. I can already see that it's going to be so much easier than having the carpet. So thank you guys for watching. So this will be for my rabbits. And this is going to be for my sugar gliders in their critter nation cage. If you guys end up doing this, please let me know and let me know what species you're doing it for. I think it could work well for a lot of different animals because who doesn't love laminate flooring? Thank you guys again. Be sure to comment, like, and subscribe, and see you guys in the next video.